was this drawing, this black and white drawing. Remember now, the constitutions of Freemasonry. And look up at the top. What is that? It's Lucifer, is it not? In his great chariot. That's the way they see their great God coming, the great sun god, known as Apollyon, Abaddon, Lucifer, coming in the clouds to save mankind. In the book Childhood's End, this famous science fiction writer, Arthur C. Clarke, wrote something that my friends sent chills down my back. I want to put the quote up on the screen. He sees this evidently as a good thing. You see, people for eons have pictured the beings as, well, look what he says. Read it for yourself. It was a tribute to the overlords, that's what he calls them. You see, they're returning. They're returning in UFO craft. It was a tribute to the overlord psychology and to their careful years of preparation that only a few people fainted when they returned. Yet there could have been fewer still anywhere in the world who did not feel the ancient terror brushed for one awful instant against their minds before reason banished it forever. There was no mistake. The leathery wings, the little horns, the barbed tail, all were there. When these aliens return, the cameras of the world, the televisions will be focused on them. What will they look back? Arthur Clarke tells us. The most terrible of all legends, he says, has come to life out of the unknown past. Yet now it stood smiling in ebon majesty with the sunlight gleaming upon its tremendous body. In the Middle Ages, said Clarke, people believed in the devil and feared him. But this was the 21st century. It was one world. And the book Childhood's End goes on to say that people suddenly said, of course, this is the one we've been awaiting all this time. This creature with a barbed tail, with horns, with leathery wings. He is our God. Will the people of earth love their oppressor, Satan or Lucifer? I believe they will. And he will not come as some beautiful figure. Eventually he will come as he is. But because they have been brainwashed and conditioned, they will accept the most hideous form of evil. A man named Barry Kamish, he's Jewish, wrote a book a few years back called Return of the Giants. And he chronicled about UFOs, even in the Middle East and in Israel. And he warns about it. Unlike the Masons and the Arthur Clarks of this world, he finds this ominous, and he is correct. I want to read to you a final quote here by a New Age occultist, Edward Schur. He says, Lucifer is coming again, and it's a good thing. He's bringing his legions in the sky. And I'm going to quote him from his book. Yes, from his book, From Sphinx to Christ. He says, Lucifer, having regained his star and his diadem, will assemble his legions for new works of creation. Attracted by his flaming torch, celestial spirits will descend to earth. And he will send these messengers from unknown spheres to earth. Then the torch of Lucifer, he writes, will signal from heaven to earth, and the New Age Christ will answer from earth to heaven. He'll be greeted by the New Age Christ and the people of earth. But listen to me very closely. I want to read to you again, Revelation 9, verse 11. If and when planet X arrives, and all of the signs in the sky and on earth, you have seen them. Be wary, my friends. Be wary. Remember it says, and they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue hath his name Apollyon. Some would say, Tex, you're not leaving us with any hope. You're not leaving us with anything but fear for what is to come upon the earth. Now I want you to listen very close to me. God has some good news for you. He has some good news for you. Listen to Matthew chapter 24, verse 35 says, "Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away." When will these things occur? Planet X, the so-called alien supernatural beings, which are nothing more than the devil and his dark angels, when will they come? Well, they'll come right before Jesus comes. "But of that day and hour knoweth no man," said the Lord. "No, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only." Verse 37 again reminds us, "But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be, as it was in the days of Noah." Friends, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, we have weapons. It says the weapons that we have are not carnal. We have weapons to fight this. They're not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. Friends, every high thing can be brought down into obedience to Christ. How? Through the Word of God. Through the Word of God. And someday, it says in the Holy Word, that there will be a new heaven and new earths. We have something great to look forward to. And I want to remind you finally of the Gospel of Luke. And listen to these inspiring words. "You think bad things are going to come upon the earth? Look beyond the clouds. Look beyond the shadows to that great sun." And I'm not talking about the sun god. I'm talking about the Son, S-O-N, of God. "And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh." Until next time, friends, this is Tex Mars. Keep looking up.